हेलो एवरीवन, होप यू आर एन्जॉइंग द ऑनलाइन क्लासेस प्रोवाइडेड बाय वी ऑल टीचर्स। एंड टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अ न्यू चैप्टर, द हैप्पी प्रिंस। दिस स्टोरी इज ऑफ योर बुक मूमेंट्स एंड रिटन बाय ऑस्कर वाइल्ड। ऑस्कर वाइल्ड इज़ अ वेरी फेमस इंग्लिश ऑथर and he has written so many special stories for the children, okay? And in his stories we can find so many human values which is very special for the life in the modern time, okay? Oscar Wilde was an Irish author. Irish means he was of Ireland, and he had spent some time in London also, and he had written his novels, dramas, short stories in English and French. And some works of Oscar Wilde is also in Greek language. Students, here I have given you the genre of Oscar Wilde. Genre means what kind of things he has written. First thing is the epigram. Epigram means a story written in the letter format, letter communication. One letter is written to other person and other person is replying. And this kind of a story is called epigram. Drama, you all know that what is drama. Drama means a play, a story which can be enacted on the stage. Short story, what we are going to read, The Happy Prince, is a short story. And criticism means he has written some essays on the topics, different topics. Okay, that means he was master in writing. And his famous works are The Picture of Dorian Gray. It's a most famous work of Wilde. And the second is The Happy Prince and Other Story. Actually, the name The Happy Prince and Other Stories is actually the collection of some short stories. Four or five stories are there in that book. And the name of that book is The Happy Prince and Other Stories. Students, in this chapter we will see that what kind of human values are very important to make a society beautiful and helpful to others. Okay, so keeping this goodness in our mind, I am going to start the summary section. But this time you are going to have a new type of summary. Okay? Wait. Okay. Students, here you can see the first page of the story and some highlighted lines. And like this way, you are going to have the summary of this chapter. Okay? Students, this chapter is about the Happy Prince. What is Happy Prince? Why he is Happy Prince? And what is the special thing related with him? Now we are going to discover from the summary. And I will explain everything of this chapter by the highlighted lines and from my comments. Okay? High above the city, on a tall column, stood the statue of the Happy Prince. The first line clears that the Happy Prince is a statue. He was glided all over the thin leaves of fine gold. For eyes he had two bright sapphires, and a large ruby, red ruby, glowed in his sword hilt. Students, the Happy Prince is a statue, okay? And his whole body is made of valuable things, like the full body is covered with the leaf of the gold, द आईज ऑफ हैप्पी प्रिंस आर मेड ऑफ स्पायर्स एंड द सॉड हिल्ट. सॉड हिल्ट मीन्स द दिस पार्ट इज मेड ऑफ अ रेड रूबी. ओके, सो दिस इज अ स्टैचू ऑफ हैप्पी प्रिंस. वन नाइट देयर फ्लू ओवर अ सिटी अ लिटिल स्वैलो. His friends had gone away to Egypt 6 weeks before, but he had stayed behind and then he decided to go to Egypt too. Swallow. Swallow is a migratory word. Migratory word means in the different season, they change their living places. Okay? These kind of birds change their living places and from one place to another place, they go. Can you give a name of any other migratory birds? Yes. The first name comes in your mind, the Siberian ill. Yeah. So a swallow bird was just flying over the city and he was going to the Egypt, Okay. And he had flown the whole day, so he was tired and he wanted to stay in the night time. Okay, so he put himself in the statue, the Happy Prince, and he says that I have a golden bedroom. When he saw the full prince, the statue, and he finds that this prince, this statue is made of gold, so he just exclaims that night he is going to enjoy a golden bedroom. Okay. Next, what is the use of the statue? Actually, some drops of water falls upon him, and he finds himself wet. So he just exclaims, he just says that what is the use of the statue? I have highlighted this line. What is the use of the statue if it cannot keep the rain off? Okay. And he was about to fly and he was about to search the new place to stay, to spend the night. And when he was about to fly, he finds that the eyes of Happy Prince were filled with tears and tears were rolling down his golden cheeks. Then the swallow asked, "Who are you?" The statue replies, "I am Happy Prince." "Then why are you weeping?" "If you are a Happy Prince, then why are you weeping?" सोचने वाली बात है कि अगर किसी का नाम हैप्पी प्रिंस है तो फिर वो रो क्यों रहा है. ये तो वही बात हो गई कि जिसका नाम शांति है वही सबसे ज्यादा चिल्ला रही है. ओके, सो देन द स्टैचू एक्सप्लेन्स एवरीथिंग रिलेटेड विथ हिम. व्हेन आई वाज अलाइव एंड हैड अ ह्यूमन हार्ट आई डिड नॉट नो व्हाट टीयर्स वर फॉर आई लिव्ड द पैलेस वेयर सॉरो is not allowed to enter my courtiers. That means he was enjoying his life when he was alive. He was a prince and he doesn't know when he was alive, he doesn't know what is actually the sorrow. But after his death, he was just made a statue and standing high on the city, he can see the misery of the city. He can see the poverty of the city. He can see the pain of the people. Okay. So, he requests Swallow to do a work for him. He explains about a sea mistress, whose child is very ill with fever and the lady has nothing to give him. Okay, so he requests to Swallow to take out the ruby from the sword hilt and give it to the bird which was very helpful. The bird which was very helpful, who was very helpful, he accepts the order of the prince and he just takes out the ruby from the prince's sword and flew towards the home of that lady. He just put the ruby on the table, okay, and he just flapped the wings above the boy, because he was just tossing on his bed because of the fever. So he did a very good job. The swallow did a very good job, and then returned to the prince and said that I have done your work. And he was about to fly. Then again the prince requested to him that to stay one night longer. The bird accepts the prince's proposal, and this time the prince explains about a young man who was trying to finish a story, a play, for the director of the theater, but he could not write because of the cold. He had nothing to make fire in his home. So the prince requested to him to take one sapphire of the eye and give it to that young man. The swallow, first not ready to do this, but he accepts the proposal of the prince, and then he just plucked out one eye, which is made of sapphire, and give it to the young man who was trying to finish the story, the play, for the theater director. Okay, so this time the prince had lost his one eye. Students, actually you can see that the prince is doing good. A statue, which is a non-living thing, is doing goodness, is doing welfare things for the people, for the poor people. Okay, that means he is showing the humanity from his side. And this time he again requested the swallow bird to stay one more night, and this time he explains about a match girl. Here you can see match girl. She has let her matches fall in the gutter, and because of that she has spoiled all the matches, and her father will beat her if she does not bring some money to home, and she is crying because of the fear of the father. Okay, so the prince request the swallow bird to pluck out the second eye of the statue. But this time the swallow become very angry, because he tells that if he plucks out the second eye, the statue will be completely blind. Okay, but the prince, the happy prince statue, was able to make swallow in favorable to do the work as he is commanding. So he requested, and the bird plucked out the prince's second eye and give it to the match girl. The match girl is very happy to see the sapphire, the eyes of the prince, and she was just laughing and dancing. But the swallow was very sorry. Swallow was very in pain to see the condition of Happy Prince. The Happy Prince is now completely blind. Okay? So, this time, Swallow was very desperate. He was sad and he returned to the statue. And he explains everything about the little girl. But what happened next in the story? We will see in the next class. Till then, I am giving you a homework to read the chapter, the full chapter. It's a very easy chapter in language. अगर तुम लोग इस चैप्टर को सिर्फ पढ़ जाओगे तो तुमको आसानी से समझ में आ जाएगा कि what is the actual story. And one more thing, the language level is very easy in this chapter. So my advice is to read this chapter completely throughout. Okay, this will improve your English skill. And the next part and the final summary part you will receive in my next class. Okay, till then, have a nice day.